Hello, folks. Hopefully we are live. Living on the edge just a little with this one. I have just applied a hot fix to this particular locomotive. Will it work? Dunno. He's hoping. He's hoping. Totally apologize for dumping you an hour ago. I'm sorry about that. It was a little bit out of my control. There's nothing to do with the game, but I have just popped in a hotfix. And just to make sure, so we're going to have a look at the JA. Don't worry about this little dialogue for the moment. Let's get in here. Just to make sure I actually succeed in getting up the hill, I'm going to do something just a little bit nasty. Yeah, it won't let me. I want to uncouple. Brr. All right. We'll push them together and then we'll do it. Okay, so welcome, if there's anyone watching at all. Yeah, let's get our reverser into forward. Let's get the little cylinder cock open. Release our brakes. Hello, Mark. No, I want you to go to more than running. I want you to go to release. There we go. Now running. Okay, that's looking vaguely promising. Stuff's happening. Yay! Alright, let's get our oiler set up. This is a very, very manual locomotive. And you'll notice that there's not a lot of rail driver going on. Because it doesn't like it very much. That looks promising. Little dribbles of goo. Alright. Let's get that so it's oiling the cylinders. We have already started to crawl along. Ah, we might as well get the generator going. Whoops, not that one. No, this one. There we go. And let's turn on the headlight. That's exciting, isn't it? You do everything in this loco. Everything's for yourself. Now, I have got the automatic fireman turned on. Now, can I uncouple now? No. Alright, so what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to reverse just a little bit. Just so I can squeeze those couplers up, and hopefully then it'll let me uncouple them. No, still won't. Alright, we're just going to have to try and take all of them up the hill, aren't we? Let's see what happens. I don't have a lot of confidence in my abilities. It's not the loco, let me point that out. I've spent quite a bit of time with NZ TS today. That's a little loud in my ear. What's the volume on your end, Mark? I just had one last crack at climbing. Is it going to let me? It'll let me put brakes on. Yeah, no problem. But not uncouple. Sometimes I love this game. Well, our brakes have released, so let's pull on. Let's go. Now, the loco looks and sounds really cool. A little loud, let me bring it down just a tad. Hopefully that's better. Close so cylinder pops up. So she looks nice. We've got Mr. Casual driving there with his arm out of the window. He seems to always do that, no matter what kind of pickle I get him in. So, we're on our way. Now, I've been trying to get this thing up this bank pretty much all day. And I've just applied the second of two hot fixes. One related to problems I was having, and another one that I don't actually know what it's for, but I thought I'd put it on anyway, since they were nice enough to send it to me. So, actually it's feeling a little bit better, I have to say. Now, this loco loves being driven on a fully open regulator, which is a bit weird in my experience of steam locomotives, but I know some of them do like to work that way. So we'll do that. Let's have a get rid of him and get put that up So at the moment we have only 146 PSI of oil. That's not pretty good. We need 200. Probably using a bit much steam when I was starting out there. I have got the automatic climbers turned on. And we're cruising through the foothills of New Zealand. We're going to get into some pretty awful gradients. So swing around, we're going to have a look at the pretty beastie. And we are playing one of the scenarios that comes with it. You do need the... you can make your own scenarios and put them on some other route, as long as you can find something with 3 foot six track. But you do need the New Zealand Midlands route to run this. How's the volume now, Mark? So I'm having to drive completely with the keyboard, which is not fond of the rail gun. But I think that might be a problem on my end. And I did actually break TS today, so that was a bit exciting. There's a JA a few kilometres down the road from you, regularly in steam with the red carriages. I wanted to visit the Kingston Flyer when I visited South Island, which I think is a JA. But unfortunately, it was not. That made me sad. I couldn't even go and look at it. That's okay. It's locked up in the shed. Good volume, excellent. It's a little quiet on my end now, but that's okay. Got some good speed going now. Boiler pressure is still not brilliant, so let's use a bit less steam, I think. The other thing you would be a little bit careful of if you start driving this one is, and I'm going to risk it, it doesn't like this HUD at all. Really dislikes it. So it's much easier to drive using the little mini HUD to get your gradients and using the F5 train information. So if you see me looking up in the top left all the time, that's what I'm looking for. But it's been a very fun day of learning because, like most very manual locomotives, you really do need to get to know it quite well. That's okay. I have to say it's got beautiful sound. No indication of looping or other strange things in the whistle and motion gear. It just sounds nice and it's quite fluid in the way it increases and decreases. Now these little pauses I don't think are anything to do with this locomotive. I've been having some problems with TS. And as you can see, there's this weird artifact happening up in the top right corner of my screen that I haven't been able to get rid of either. And that's definitely not this route because it happens in everything. So how are we going gradient-wise? 165, that's not too bad. And our steam pressure is built back up. We're back up to 199. Have a look around in the cab. There's a lot in here. So one of the things I glossed over there at the start, I have to finish setting up now anyway, is the oiler. We're going faster now. And 15, 18, 19, 17, that's probably okay. It's probably a bit excessive actually. Just bring those back just a tiny bit. Especially that one, because it's only raining the compressor. I think I should watch where I'm going. Nah, let's keep going. Let's see how that makes it. See if I took too much out. Okay. Need to bring down. Too bland. So it is quite an amazing cab. There's a lot in here. So lots of controls for the fireman that I'm not bothering with at the moment because I'm still trying to learn how to drive this thing. It is quite a complex one. get going with. And I do know a bit about steam, as people will never know. No, I turned them down too much. Go back there. Too much. So which ones are too low? Our left gland. We have some very nice gauge work happening in here with the brakes. Nice and clear. So we've got the main reservoir on the train, which is sitting on a comfortable 1920 at the moment. Our equalising reservoir is 80, our train brake height is 80 pounds. Zero on the brake cylinders, no great surprise there. And we've got a nice flow gauge up here, which really helps you understand what's going on at the back of the train. So it tells you what's going on at the front. And this is really handy for knowing what's going on at the back. So I'll cover that when we actually do some braking. That's a little sooner or later. And we're dropping speeds, and my guess is we're starting to go uphill. We are, 160 gradient. That's okay. What I'm curious about is, can I uncouple those cars now? No. Not gonna let me. Because I have a faint suspicion I won't make it up the hill with those cars in tow. So you've just done a reinstall as well. Mine wasn't going to desktop, but I was having some interesting issues. Did a verify of integrity, and that kept finding a file that wasn't preparing. Now, which one's too low? After a while, you get these things right, and it's okay. It can bug them. And we've got the, almost everybody needs to be able to do that thing. Is that going to be enough? Let's see if the warning goes away. It has. We can get back to driving. There we go. Steam pressure's good. Going along at a good speed. I do have to slow down soon, though. I think we might just drop that throttle off. And we'll open up the drift valve. We've gone into full forward. Let's get the cylinder cocked open. That's a funny noise with the drift valve going. And let's see if I can get some braking to actually happen properly. Come on here. Come on. Here you want it. Here you want it. Yay! Here we go. Bit more. That should probably do it. I want to get down to 25 mile an hour. Something tells me I'm not going to get down to 25 mile an hour because I'm doing 52 and I'm getting faster. How about a lot more? Ah, that feels better. Feels like it's actually having an effect now. Now, by the time I get this thing slowed down, it'll be time to speed up again. That's okay. Did I mention I was still quite rubbish at driving this thing? Hello, Cayman, how are you? Oop, big bridge. Got the fat look at the big bridge. Because it's cool. There's those weird little pauses again. That was part of the problem I was trying to solve. That isn't the train, I'm pointing out. It's happening on other trains and routes as well. I'm going to get back in the cabin at least. Great. A bit more. Come on. Oh, I've made it. Stop! No! Are you going to let me release or not? Yay! Should be in running now. There we go. That's where we want it to be. So we'll let the brake system recover, take care of itself. That'll be fine. Get that back into full forward gear and get some throttle on. And I'll just take the opportunity since they stopped. Can I get rid of them now? No, I still can't. Ooh, got rid of two of them. That'll do. That'll be enough to get me up the hill. Sorry, guys. I'm just going to leave you on the bridge. That's okay, isn't it? It's a bit mean, isn't it? Bye-bye. You're looking forward to Steam on TSW? So am I. Steam's hard, man. It really is. Alright, close that cylinder, Cox. That's sounding kind of promising. Going up a little bit of ingredients. I'm not too surprised it's working a bit. Alright, let's get some more throttle on. We've got all of our throttle on now. Looks like we've still got brakes releasing, so we've got the flow gauge, what we want and what it is. Start bringing this reverser back a bit now. And that'll help with our steam rate, which I'm sure I'm chewing through. No, not too bad, actually. What I'm looking at up here is the steam generation rate versus the steam usage rate. As long as the usage is less than the generation, you're okay. Mostly ignoring the other stuff. Alright, we've got our reverser at 36. Let's put it at 40. That'll do. Likes being at about 40. You can see that the train brakes almost come up on the back because the flow gauge is almost equalised on the other one. So it's quite handy to have that. A green signal out here in the absolute middle of nowhere on our single running track. The scenery on this route, I know the Midlands route's been out for a while, but the scenery on this route is just amazing. And I have to say, man, does it make my computer work hard. I actually have to reduce my settings a little bit. But that's okay, because you need a lot of scenery to convey New Zealand, especially when you get into the gorge country, it's just beautiful. And they've done a pretty nice job of it, I have to say, and we'll see that shortly, because we're not too far off now. Oh, it's time for another tunnel. There's a bit to learn for steam. I do like that in TSW they're talking about an easy mode and a hard mode. So that would be good. Oops, before we go in the tunnel, I saw a little bit of the glacial gorge there with the river flowing through. And I have to say, that's spot on for the scenery. That's not why we're here. We're not here for the scenery. We're here for the locomotive. Yes, it's the 64-bit version of Cayman. I only run the 64. How are we doing? Speed's pretty good. Bring the reverser back a bit more. Down a little bit, going over another bridge between two tunnels. There's a lot of tunnels. And, we're about to pop out of tunnels for a fairly long way, so that'll be good. And everything else is looking pretty okay, so let's see if I make it up the hill this time. Now that pause there actually is just the level of detail that's drawing for the route. It's huge. And I have to say, it's pretty good. Really like it. And the train's pretty nice too. Get in a bit closer after we pass all these trees. So I've been looking forward to this coming out because, you know, New Zealand, Australian neighbours. There's not a lot of Australian content for TS, but there's a bit of New Zealand. And it's awesome to have a steamer come out. And I know that TrainSim New Zealand have been working on this for ages. And I believe that they actually built the steam loco first, its original version of it anyway. And then they built the route to run it on. It's kind of cool. Gradients before we get into the tunnel. We're going up on 1 in 70 now. reverser, so we don't slow down too much. Let's slow down our rate of fall a bit. It's still coming down though. Working on that. Now last time to get up the hill I had to get rid of three characters, so we've got rid of two. Let's see what happens this time. Let's see if I can do it. I have to say I'm not that confident, so if it gets stuck, keep expecting dinosaurs to jump out of the underbrush. It's about to go back into the tunnel, so let's jump back in the cab. Speed's doing okay. Going downhill, we're about to come through staircase. Not stopping the staircase though. We're going to rocket through staircase. In fact, we're rocketing through just a little bit rough, to be honest. That's okay, we'll be going uphill again shortly. We'll lose all this speed. If we stay on the corners. Uh-oh. We need some lubrication. Wrong. That one. There we go. What do we need from our lubrication? Okay, we need 21 drops a minute. Give it a bit more to everybody. If the loco stops bouncing around, it would be a little bit easier. Oh, another cool bridge. This one's got a fence on it though. And a tunnel. 67 miles an hour, what am I doing? I think we're upside down in the tunnel. I should have been watching the speed, not the lubricator. How good was that? Not good at all. You know what I'll try and do though? Can I do, there we go. Beautiful. It's a good thing I saved earlier. That wasn't very clever, was it? I'm looking at lubricator, and look at my speed and go, uh-oh. Now this puts us right at the start of the gradient. So let's just... Like the brakes are all off. Good. And about 44%. That's probably a good place to be. Because we are, in fact, getting into the big gradient. This is the hard one. We're going to get into a 1 in 50 through here. So, Mark says that they have one passenger train a day on the route. It leaves Christchurch in the morning, returns very early evening. Very much a tourist experience. Yeah, you'd think I'd learn, wouldn't you? Look how fast it's going. But, to be honest, I don't want to take that speed off, because look what's coming. I hope it gets around the corner. This might not be good. This might not be good at all. What I might just do is at least drop the throttle off. I hope we don't come off somewhere, because I'm doing ridiculous speed. I think the top speed of these locos is something like 40. We're doing 60. You reckon we'll get around this corner? I don't know. Stay on! Stay on! Ah, no! All right, we're going to go back to that save point, and this time I'm going to slow it down because, you know. It's funny, though. Quit. Yes. I think some of my poor people fell off the bridge then. Look at that one hanging off the edge there. Wow, terrible. Absolutely terrible. I promise I'll behave myself this time. I'll slow it down. Standard. Just hope it lets me resume it again. Yay. All right. Maybe the hotfix has done its job. It seems to be a little bit more powerful. Let's get in the cab. Let's ruffle that fella off. And we definitely want some brakes. Come on. Put it down to about. Release. Let's stop here. No. There we go. 45. That's not too bad. Just starting the gradient. Let's get the throttle back up. And our reverse is only on 4. Alright, let's see how we go. Steadily losing speed. That's no great surprise. Of course, the brakes probably haven't still finished coming off yet. Looks like they're just getting there. This was a really competent demonstration, wasn't it? So cool. Yeah, we're going a bit slower this time. We're only doing 40 miles an hour. That'll be okay. Come on, game. Don't crap out on me now. I need to be third time lucky, game. Regulator fully open. We're starting to hit this gradient, so 1 in 53. Rather a heavy one from here on out. So let's see if I can actually manage to get us up the hill. Steam generation is I'm using a little bit more than I'm actually making, which isn't great. Get out of these power lines, that looks a bit open. Certainly starting to lose some speed now. Now what I've been trying to do, is there a release date? Yes! In about 4 hours. 3 hours, something like that. Tomorrow! At least that's the plan. Still losing speed. Ooh, don't freeze. I was hoping my rebuild of the game would solve that freezing problem, but it hasn't, so I'm going to have to look elsewhere as to what's causing that. Maybe one of the delightful Windows 11 updates, perhaps. How far have we go to the top of the hill? 1.16. This is not feeling too awful. I'm not going to say I'm confident, because, you know, that wouldn't be good. This would not end well. It might not end well. The steam usage for Jake has dropped a little, which is good to see. I'm probably over-lubricating now, but to be honest, I'm going to ignore that. Won't hurt anybody if we over lubricate. As long as we don't run out. How far are we? 0.79. Ooh. 2 mile an hour. I can see the signal for the top of the hill. Just saw it glinting in the distance. You can do it, little train. You can do it. Now, I'm hoping the hotfixes actually come out in Steam release straight away. Hopefully they will. This is two. I have to say, the Train City New Zealand guys, absolutely amazing. Totally responsive. Because when this complete nufty like me contacts them out of the blue and goes, I've got a problem with your new train. I need a bit of help. And they were like, yeah, okay, let's have a look. So absolutely fantastic. Hats off to them. Oh, 0.39 of a mile to go. I'm going to turn the generator off. Obviously did. Oh well, I'm going to save the steam. Turn it back on at the top. Make this, you know. Now I've got the whole train too. See, now I'm suddenly worried because I've got the whole train. So here we go. Because I think we're coming into Avoca. There's still a bit more gradient after Avoca. And I don't need to stop and recover steam because my boiler's got plenty of water and I've got plenty of steam, so we're doing okay. Not to mention, if I stop, I might not actually get going again. I'm trying to get us out of the power lines, or actually, they're probably telegraph lines. Maybe some of them are power. Telegraph on the bottom, power on the top, I guess. Oh, we're starting to pick up speed. This is good. Don't think we're supposed to stop here. No, it's a go via. Now we're going to go via Creeburn. Oh, we're picking up speed. I'm so happy. That's my steam usage rate. We're still a bit lower. That's another one of those horrible pauses. Started happening really recently. It's only affecting TS, and I need to go through and see what Windows 11 updates have applied in the last week or so, and try and see what's causing this. Is it some bit annoying? I think I should get onto the Trains in New Zealand guys and go, "Hey, I got over the hill." Go, we're surprised. Is that pretty going? Just flattening out a bit, 185, so still a little bit steep. Looping through the countryside a bit more now. Z guys that the hotfix actually worked. Ah, how long is this route? Let's have a quick look. Big. How does that sound? It's just big. I don't think you'd be unhappy if you wanted a long run. I personally prefer to stop everywhere, but that's life. Is that a road or another track? No, it's a road. Kilometres. Awesome, Mark. Glad to have you around. Don't think I would have been quite comfortable trying to Google that right now. I'm going to hit my head on a pole in a minute. And I feel they've done pretty well on this area. Sound like I'm slowing down a bit. Coming up, yes. Now I can make another hill. Bridge pond. Yeah, it's funny, all of these releases and things coming through TSW, and you know, the water in TS is still better. More bridge corn. I have to say, I really enjoy visiting New Zealand. It's quite amazing. You get all these nice plains, and then there's these mountains that just have erupted out of the ground at some point. So many bridges. Pop back into the cab. Read out the top left, that is the F5 key. So if you've got another HUD on, you can't have it, but press F5 once and then press it again and you'll get the second part. The steam usage rate is most useful. It's a general principle, you want to keep your usage rate below your generation rate. I noticed British Ace is streaming this too, but he probably hasn't had the hotfix. So I hope he's doing okay. Yeah, so if you turn on one of the other HUDs, like F3, it disappears. But as soon as you turn off the HUD, it comes back. Just loping along like a greyhound. Notice I'm controlling by keyboard, not my usual rail driver tools, because when I was having issues, I got rid of every outside possible source of what could be going wrong, just to try and eliminate causes. So I'll have to try it again with the rail driver. Coming up on the creaky burn. Our water level 3,000. You know, if it wasn't going so fast, I'd stop and fill up the water. Hope there's water somewhere else on the route.
Gotta like that whistle though. Pretty impressive. Latest version just loves the speed. Keep waiting for it to throw a rod. Starting to lose some speed now, which is good because I'm pretty sure I'm in a 45 mile an hour zone or something. Yeah, I am. Look at that. Might be speeding just a little bit. So I take it from what you were saying before, Mark, that you're a local. What about you, Cayman? Have you visited New Zealand? Have your arm out now, fella. North of Wellington. You get his arm back out. There he goes. Happy little man. Running 5 miles over the limit now. That's a bit better. If you get the opportunity, Cayman, absolutely go. And, spend as much time as you can, because there's plenty to see. Everybody in Australia thinks New Zealand's looking. But no, it's not. Last time I was there, we stayed in Queenstown, and I think the only New Zealanders that I actually saw in Queenstown was the guy at immigration, the policeman that pulled me over for a breath test, and no, I hadn't been drinking, much to his surprise, and the guy at immigration on the way out. Pretty sure they were really the only New Zealanders that I actually ran into. Everybody else were backpackers from all over the world. Once we got out of there and we went to Dunedin, and we almost got all the way up to Christchurch just driving along. Didn't quite make it before we started to run out of time. But on that side of the country, there were plenty of locals. And you do need a long time for a visit, Mark, because things like the landscape changes no matter where you go, the architecture changes all over the place. There's so many different influences from different areas of New Zealand from around the world. And there's so many trains to play with. Supposed to be doing 37. That's okay. I'm going to go 31. That'll be fine. Honest, Your Honour. wheel from the train behind me. Going around the corner. Now, I've done some work with one of the water companies. I don't think they exist anymore, actually. I think they got eaten by water care, but it was Metro Water at the time. I think they're gone now. I did quite a bit of exploring around North Island when I was doing that. And then we went for a family holiday to South Island. Explored a bit of that. And I think we scratched the surface. I think we were there for about 2.5 weeks or something. Saw plenty, but... I have a faint suspicion. I'm going to have to put some brakes on. Certainly got my regulator off. Oh, we are going down a remarkably steep hill. That'd explain it. First time I've got this far on this route. See how we go with that set for a little while. Not making a difference. No, we're getting faster. See how that goes. That's slowing us down. Hopefully it's enough. 60 mile an hour into a 37th corner. Your fingers. Didn't want to be this house, I might land on them. That's better. It's off. And when you're using the brakes on this thing, releasing? No, not yet. I have to get into running. There we go. I only put it into release, and if you have it in release too long, you overcharge the brake pipe. What sorts of ugliness happens? We're still going downhill? We are. We need to test. Up again. If Cass has water. Hello, Roy. Haven't seen Roy for weeks. Sadly, I'm back at work tomorrow. See you tomorrow, Roy. There is a water tower. Going right past the little tower right now. You know, I was actually pretty close to pulling that off then. It's pretty close. Not there, but... Alright, let's get these coming off. Oh, I want you to go around one more knot. There we go. I'll put you in the loops. Backwards, little loco. Backwards. There we go. Hopefully that's enough to stop the train. Pretty good. Open the cylinder cocks up. And stop spraying oil everywhere. Ah. Relaxation. I'm glad we found a water tower. I was beginning to get a little bit worried. So where are we actually going on this one? Coraline, then Arthur's Pass. And then Arthur's Pass turntable. Not too long to go. 10:20, 10:40, so about another 20 minutes, I guess. That'll be cool. She's a thirsty little thing. Actually, the amount of water has stopped going up, but it's still loading it. No, don't put more in there. It's determined to put more in there. Alright, you put more in there then. You do you. You do what you want to do. God, it's got to be full now. What happens if we're just leaving it like that? Alright, forward gear. Cylinder cocks are open, and let's put our oiler back on. Release the brake. And release the kraken. So as I'm taking off, I gave it a little bit of throttle to start. Now I'll bring that all the way up. And I'll start bringing our reverser back. Decrease our cutoff and decrease the amount of steam we're using and try and get the right balance of acceleration versus steam usage. We're not bad at the moment because we're using just a little bit more than we're creating. 23,000 versus 21,000. We are picking up speed nicely, so I can put the reverser back a bit more. And we are going downhill, which is why we're not having too much trouble. So what I might even do is come back in here and drop the throttle off and just open up the drift valve, which just lets a little bit of steam through. We can just roll along for free. I'm almost tempted to go look at British Ace's stream and see how he's coping. More out.
at this point.
Ready to get their screenshot ready. There we go. Are we still going downhill? No, we're on the flat now. Party on, dude. And cylinder pops up open. Good. You open up the cylinder cocks because if you've got condensate in the cylinders and you try and squash it, water doesn't squash very well. Close the strip valve now too, so still powering again. Can't get further away. What do you think, Mark? Have they captured the scale of a glacial gorge? Now, if you've just joined in, the strange pauses are not the train or the game. There's something happening on my computer which is doing weird things. This panning is much easier with the controller. I don't even have one of those plugged in at the moment. Moon! And some nice swamps. And we should tell that guy that made the Sacramento route that this is how you make a swamp. All the way around. I think I should save. Since my PC's misbehaving so much. Sit for a bit. seems to be having the desired effect. I wonder if this valley ever floods. I thought I got the handle in the right place this time. There we go. Come on, PC, you can do it.
You can do it.
Oh, just in time. How big is that? This landscape just completely dwarfs the railway. At least the drift valve would have kept some steam going in there. I wonder where that line goes. Off into the distance there. Let's see what the map says. There's like a little yard there. It's a ballast pit. Fair enough. It's a good place for rocks. Naughty guard hasn't put the marker lights on. Naughty. Can I do it from here? No. Come on, Freezy PC, you can do it. Really is apple juice. Now, I'd love to take you through all the fireman's controls on this locomotive, but I haven't been there yet. I've been busy trying to learn the locomotive. So I can get it down the track, and it's been an interesting day. One or two challenges. But it's an awesome machine. It is so rare to get one that both looks good and sounds good. You usually get one camp or the other. This one, I have to say, fits in both quite nicely. Let's get that headlight back on speaking of sound. You can hear the pile spin up. Goes. Yay, headlight. Welcome to Coraline. much more sedate pace. Probably more like reality. So if you're thinking about grabbing this loco and you've got the Midlands route, it's very realistic. You've got a learning curve on your hands, but don't despair. Give it a crack. You'll get there. You can get onto the Trains of New Zealand people via their website, and they are most helpful. Let's find their website. Pop it in the chat. I know that Steph, who's the guy that scripted this, has put up a pretty good video on YouTube for how to drive it. In fact, let me see if I can find it. Somewhere around here, I've got a link to it. Good, British Ace has got the update too, so he'll be going fine. He's a really nice guy. If you haven't watched the stream, he's somewhat more popular than me. That's okay. Where is it? Where is the link? There it is. No, that's not it. Here it is. Going. I've been ignoring it for a little while I find the link. Hello, Blue Moon Nights. That's the link to the How to Drive video. So, if you have a go at it, give it a crack. It's enjoyable once you learn it. Now, I probably learned maybe 80% of what I need to know to run this effectively. So I'm running okay. I can get it over hills now, which is a big change from this morning, and I couldn't do that. I have yet to touch much of this side of the universe, which is the fireman's side of things. I know what the controls are. I know what they do, but I haven't touched them. So I don't know how easy this one is to fire or not. It looks like it's a pretty good steamer because almost no matter what I ask it to do, it just sort of does. No matter how silly. More miles to go to Arthur's Pass. I think I might play some more of this one on Sunday in the morning. Try and squeeze in a bit more learning between working tomorrow and being on the real railway on Saturday. So when I come home on Sunday evening, I have to learn it. Very slight upgrade. That noise you can hear at the moment is the fireman's injector line, putting water in the boiler. And stopped. If you want to, you can actually slow down the gauges if you desire to do that. You may need to use the lubricator can from time to time to fill this up. Everything else is all usable. That is just vast. With the moon peeking out from behind the mountains up there. Certainly climbing a hill again. Been lulled into a false sense of security thinking this was dead flat, but of course it's not. Notice we were losing speed. Maintaining it now, just a slight increase. Looks like we're getting a little bit steeper this morning. Bit more oomph and build up some speed for this hill. People are really excited. One day I'll do a video explaining how the steam valves actually work and how it goes forwards and backwards and speeds up and slows down. To go. Looks like we've got a fairly steady climb. But coping nicely. Quite a bit of coal. Lots of squashed dinosaurs and plants, but not squashed enough to become dinosaurs. Erosion when you get a lot of water. Just needs a big jet boat, doesn't it? Just come and sit at this corner and watch it come along. This looks like a fairly sharp bend, actually. Looks like a few locos might have come a cropper on this bend. Definitely getting steeper again. ...2.38 miles to our final destination. Almost, anyway. Choice of going up a steep hill like this. It's better, I'm using less than I'm making now. steam usage rate versus the steam generation rate on that display. So much cooler if it was just a nice visual arrow of steam. That'd be so good, but you know, it's an old game. Has its roots right back in 2001, MSTS, Microsoft Train Simulator. It's not quite that game, but it's where it started. So that was built by Kuju Entertainment, and then there was Railworks, which it's still called if you look in your Steam folders. Too much about my steam pressure much longer. None of those delightful little freezers my PC is taking to doing. How far away this place really is. Not far at all. I think I might start slowing down. I think we're actually supposed to stop in the platform. Amazing how the electric lines are held up by wooden poles. Are we actually all in the platform? No, need to move ahead a little bit. Okay, I don't need to move ahead a little bit. All good. Train brake on. That'll do. Let's get it uncoupled. Now, where are we off to next?
Turntable Road up there. Okay. Is it just set for me, or do I have to do it? We are there. How nice. Looks like it's actually set for us. All right. So reverses in full forward. Cylinder cocks are open. We're still oiling, so that's fine. Release the train brake, even though we're not connected anymore. Release the locomotive brake. And away we go. Switch to it's going to stop, or am I going to fall off the end of the pit? Our pump, turn off the lubrication. Yay! Well, that was a bit of a journey, wasn't it? All right then. So we had a fun locomotive. We got it over a hill. We only had two derailments. Whoa. Naughty. Naughty. But thank you very much for watching, folks. I will continue my learning enterprises with this one, and hadn't actually scheduled a stream for Sunday morning, so I will add a new one for the New Zealand Railways Class JA, and we might have a bit more of a look at the Midland line as well, and have a bit more of a play. So thanks for joining in. Sorry to delay things, a little out of my control. And have a good one. See you later. Thanks for watching, folks. I hope you enjoyed it. I always like to get your feedback in the form of likes and comments, because they help me understand what you want. Give the channel a subscribe and click on the tinkly thing so you don't miss out on any new stuff. And thanks for your ongoing support. And please, be safe out there.